Welcome back. This is the Candidates Forum for the 2012 student election. We now have the candidates running for the Director of Community Relations for SGA. Each member of the panel has a prepared set of questions to be asked in advance. The same question will be asked of each candidate by the panel members. You are expected to give brief, direct answers. You will be given approximately 1 minute to answer the question. After answering the question, you will be asked to give a closing statement. With that said, let's begin. Ms. Lilly, you have the first question.
Mr. Curry, what do you plan to change or add to the way things are now?
I would like to add the fact that students aren't aware of, they're not aware of that we even have an SGA. I was, you know, told by one student that he thought, you know, this SGA wasn't, you know, necessarily real. So I plan to add and change that and, you know, be an advocate as part of, you know, the student body, because, you know, being a student first means you know and you feel what students want and what the students need.
Ms. Howard.
Mr. Curry, how will you go about promoting the importance of community service to other students?
I would talk with, you know, the students I know and the students I don't know. Community service is, you know, a great way to, you know, have something to build character, to build something. It isn't, you know, shouldn't be just looked at, you know, oh, I'm not getting paid for it, you know, so I'm not gonna do it. But, you know, it could, to me, it seems that if I were to, you know, do a lot of volunteer work, you know, at least it builds something and it says something about me. It says a volume that says, hey, at least he, you know, that guy's a go-getter. He's motivated. He, you know, he keeps his feet moving.
Thank you.
Ms. Williams.
Mr. Curry, what outreach, advocacy, or community service programs are you currently involved in?
I'm currently involved in the DMSI program, which is Diverse Male Students Initiative. And it focuses on the diversity on campus, and it focuses on a lot of motivating history, a lot of motivation towards going towards your classes, if you need tutoring, if you need advice. It doesn't necessarily, as long as it's, I guess you would say, appropriate, and as long as it's, you know, student related, or it can be personal related, you know, a mentoring program, you know, that one of the many of programs that we have here on campus.
Thank you.
Mr. Howard.
Mr. Curry, do you think that community service should be a requirement for graduation? Why or why not?
Well, that question kind of is a little iffy. I don't think it should necessarily be required, because it, you know, it's more of a volunteering thing, but I do think that it is very, very important. Now, having said that, you know, if it's not a requirement, of course, you know, you're not going to really get too many students not to, you know, to do it, because like, oh, it's not a requirement, it's not on my curriculum, so I'm not going to really bother with it. But it also can be put on in your portfolio or your resume, you know, at least have something that says something about you.
Thank you, Mr. Curry. Mr. Curry's running mate, Ms. LaConteur Merriweather, did not show for the forum, so you get an opportunity to summarize in 1 minute your closing statements.
Well, first thing first, I would like to, you know, thank the College Life Services and the Election Board and the panel. My closing statement is for me to be proactive, and along with me moving with the students, moving with the crowd, not necessarily doing the things that the crowd does, but moving with the crowd and being proactive and getting them to be active, you know, so that they know that, you know, it isn't just about going to classes, you know, and, you know, doing things and, you know, going about your day, which is not necessarily a bad thing, but, you know, you also want to have, you know, some, you know, in a way, you can have some fun while you're here. It doesn't just have to be, you know, a straight 2 years and then I'm gone, you know, or, you know, a straight 2 years, then you go to a four-year institution. You know, have a little fun while you're here. You know, that's another thing that I'm about, having a little fun.
Thank you, Mr. Curry. The Dean of College Life Services will give his closing remarks.
First, let me thank all of you who participated in the forum today. We appreciate your political awareness, and our panelists, thank you for being on the committee and presenting the questions today to the candidates. I would like to remind everyone that the polls will open for the election on the 21st, Saturday, the 21st of April, and close midnight on the 27th of April. To vote, you must go to MyPGCC, the student portal, and click on the student election icon and cast your vote. Again, that's Saturday, April 21st through Friday, April 27th. Please tell everyone to sign on to the student portal. Click on the student icon, the student election icon, and cast your vote. Dr. Baker Brown.
Thank you, Dean Nicholson. I wish to thank all the candidates who participated in today's forum. I wish you all good luck. On behalf of the President, Dr. Charlene Dukes, the Vice President for Student Services, Dr. Tyon Lee, the Dean of College Life Services, Mr. Malvers Nicholson, the Program Director of College Life Services, Ms. Paulette McIntosh, and the Students Election Committee, thank you for taking the time to represent the Prince George's Community College student body. We would like to use this opportunity to encourage the entire Prince George's Community College student body to get out and vote. Remember, if you don't vote, you have accepted someone else's choice. Election day is April 21st, as the dean said, through to the 27th, and it closes at midnight. So vote, and make sure your friends vote as well. Have a great afternoon.